Rhode Show Kitchen this morning, thanks to Discover Newport. Chef Deborah Burka is here. Pineapples on the Bay, swordfish tacos is what we are making today. So if you were in the mood for some seafood, sun is shining outside right now, you're looking for some seafood, way to mix it up, this is the way to do it. Good morning.
Good morning.
So be honest with me, did you come here to cook for us just because it's been so busy down at the restaurant that this is going to be the relaxing place to be today?
This actually is fairly relaxing this morning.
See, all is good. That's why we're glad you're here today. This looks like a pretty simple recipe.
It is.
Easy to run out to the store and, you know, when the show's over and pick up some of these items. What do we need to actually put this together?
So I've got some fresh swordfish here, some shredded red cabbage, a citrus marinade that I'll explain to you how to make. It's really very simple. And then a mango salsa.
That mango salsa. Man, if I had some chips, that mango salsa looks awesome.
Yeah, you could definitely eat it just as a side or a little appetizer. Yeah. And then some flour tortillas and a little lemon wedge.
All right, for anyone who hasn't bought swordfish before, what do you need to look for? I mean, those look like pretty big pieces of the fish itself.
Yeah, so I mean, each of these is about a portion, about 6 to 7 ounces. You want to look for firm flesh, you know, not overly fishy in smell,
sure.
And a bright kind of color to it.
So. Does swordfish have a fishy taste to it, or is it kind of...
I'd say it's somewhere in the middle.
Some fish really does.
Yeah.
It has like that really fishy, overpowering, you know,
flavor. It's not quite as strong as maybe like a salmon, but not as mild as, you know, a cod or a haddock,
okay.
per se.
All right, so you can put this together with some of that salsa, and you are good to go. You get some things to wrap them in, and we'll be all set in just a little bit. Sounds good. All right, we'll put this together. Talk about what's going on down at the restaurant, because it's been busy. Back to you.
Now we want to send it back into the kitchen. Michaela, take it away.
Hey, thanks so much. Pineapples on the Bay is the place, but Chef Deborah is not making pineapples. We're making swordfish tacos, actually. And you have had the swordfish kind of, what, soaking in
So it's been marinating. So this is what it looks like ahead of time. And then this is the citrus marinade, which you would just go ahead and pour over it, and you can mix it. You can let it refrigerate in either the bowl, or what we actually do is put it into a Ziploc bag, and that way it's able to kind of coat it all around. So this one has been marinating.
How long would you suggest that it sits for?
I would do at least an hour. You can do overnight as well, just to let the flavors kind of soak through the meat entirely.
And what flavors went into that citrus marinade?
So it has a couple different kinds of juices, lime juice, pineapple juice, lemon juice, and then it has some shallots, salt and pepper, a little bit of oil, and a little rice wine vinegar.
Beautiful. And that all that citrus always pairs so nicely with seafood,
exactly.
Especially swordfish. Okay, so we have the swordfish there that's been marinating.
Yep.
Our pan is nice and hot.
So what you're going to do is just go ahead and you can pour everything right into the pan. And you're just going to let it cook right in the marinade, and that continues to kind of infuse the flavor into the swordfish itself.
Now, about how long should this cook for? Because I notice you have already broken it down into chunks there.
Yeah, so, I mean, depending on the level of heat that you're using, it's probably going to cook for about 3 to 4 minutes.
Great. So this is an easy fish to work with as
Absolutely.
Well. If you've never cooked swordfish before, this is an easy one to
it
do
is,
with.
It is, yeah. It holds up well. It's not too tender and flaky in the same way that a white fish would be. It's going to hold up better.
Yeah, it's a little meatier. I love
exactly.
the taste of swordfish. And in case anyone's wondering, is this a fish that you have to be aware of the little bones? Because I know a lot of times you get a different fish and you have to be aware, you just have to be careful when you're chewing it or when
right.
you're filleting it yourself.
So it doesn't have as many of the small bones inside. And when you buy it at the store in the steaks like that, you shouldn't really have to worry about that so much.
They've already cared for that. All
yes.
right, perfect. So now you know what you're looking for. And like she said, it's really easy to do. Pour all that marinade in there with the swordfish. That's going to be done in just a bit. And when we come back, we're going to assemble those tacos.